Welcome children, take up your geography book, pollution, preventive measures. Before explaining this chapter, let me give you some introduction. Introduction. Pollution is the contamination of air, soil or water by the discharge of harmful substances. What is pollution? It is the contamination of air, soil or water when there is discharge of harmful substances. Pollution prevention is the reduction or elimination of pollution at a source. Now, pollution prevention, how to prevent the pollution? It is the reduction or the elimination of pollution as a source. Pollution prevention occurs when raw materials, water energy and other sources are utilized more efficiently when less harmful substances are substituted to hazardous one and when toxic substances are eliminated from the production of process. Now, pollution prevention. How can we prevent pollution? Pollution prevention. Where it occurs? It occurs when raw materials, that is water energy and other resources, we utilize it more efficiently. We use it more efficiently in an efficient way when less harmful substances they are substituted for the hazardous one and when these toxic substances, they are reduced, means they are eliminated, they are turned out from the production process. By reducing the use of production of hazardous substance and by operating more efficiently, we protect human health, strengthen our economic well-being and preserve the environment. Now, by reducing the use and production of hazardous substance and by operating more efficiently, we protect the human health, increase our economic well-being and even preserve the environment. Preventive measures. There are several measures that can be adopted by the people to reduce pollution to save our environment. Now, several measures can be adopted by the people so that they could reduce the pollution to save the environment. First is carpooling. Number B is promotion of public transport. Then comes no smoking zone. Fourth, restricted use of fossil fuels. Fifth, saving energy. Number six, encouraging organic farming. Ambient air quality standards in India. Ambient air quality refers to the condition or quality of the air surrounding us in the outdoor. Now, what is this ambient air quality? It refers to the condition or the quality of the air which surrounds us at the outdoors. National ambient air quality standards are the standards of ambient quality. Now, national ambient quality standard, what are they? They are the standards of the ambient air quality set up by the Central Pollution Control Board that is applicable nationwide. Control Board, where it is applicable? It is applicable throughout the nation. The CPCB has been conferred this power by the year. Now, CPCB, it has confirmed this power by the Air Prevention Act of 1981. The Air Act 1981 was enacted by the central government with the objective of arresting the deterioration of air quality. Now, Air Act, that is 1981, it was enacted by the central government and with the objective that they would arrest the deterioration of the air quality. The Air Act 1981 describes the main function of the Central Pollution Control Board. Now, Air Pollution Act, that is 1981. What does it describe? It describes the main function of the Central Pollution Control Board, which are as follows. Number one, to advise the central government on many matter concerning the improvement of the quality of the air and the prevention, control and the abatement of the air pollution. First, to advise the central government on any matter which concern the improvement of the quality of the air and even prevent the control and abatement of the air pollution. Secondly, to plan and to execute a nationwide program for the prevention, control and abatement of air pollution. Now, one is to plan and then to execute throughout the country a program for preventing, control and abatement of air pollution. to provide technical assistance and guidance to the State Pollution Control Board, and even to provide help to the technical and guidance to the State Pollution Control Board. Then comes to carry out and sponsor investigation and research related to prevention, control and abatement of air pollution. Now to carry out and even to sponsor this investigation, and then to find out the things which are related to prevention, control and abatement of air pollution. To collect, compile and publish technical and statistical data related to air pollution. To collect and then to compile the public technical and statistical data which are related to air pollution. Then to lay down an annual standard for the quality of air. Then to lay down an annual standard of the quality of the air. To mandate provided to the CPCB under air. Now the to mandate provided, that is to the CPCB under the air pollution act, empowers it to set standard for the quality air. The current national ambient air quality standard were notified on 18th November 2009 by the Central Pollution Control Board. Now, current national ambient air quality standard, it was notified on 18th of November 2009 by the Central Pollution Control Board. Carpooling, ride sharing and co-driving is the sharing of car journeys so that more than one person travels. Now carpooling is what? It is the sharing of car journeys so that more than one person could travel in the same car. By having more people using one vehicle, carpooling reduces each person's cost, tolls and stress of driving. Now by sharing more and more people in one vehicle, that means carpooling, what does it do? It reduces person's cost, tolls and stress of driving. Carpooling is also more environment friendly and sustainable way to travel, as sharing journeys reduces carbon emission, traffic congestion on roads and the need of parking spaces. Now carpooling, it is also a very environment friendly and sustains the weight of traveling, and sharing journeys reduces the carbon emission, traffic congestion on the roads and need of parking spaces. Authorities often encourage carpooling, especially during the period of high pollution or high fuel prices. Now authorities often, what they do, they encourage the carpooling, especially during the period of high pollution or high fuel prices. Carpooling is more useful for people who work in places with more jobs nearby. Carpooling, where it is useful? It is useful for the people who work in the places, the job nearby, for those who live in the places with higher residential distance. Promotion of public transport. Public transport offers alternate modes of transport. Public transport, what does it do? It offers alternate modes of transport. Public transport includes train, trams and buses can relieve traffic congestion and reduce air pollution from road transport. Now public transport includes the following vehicles, that is trains, trams and buses. This gives relief to traffic congestion and even reduces the air pollution from the road transport. The use of public transport must be encouraged if a sustainable transport policy is to be developed. Now this use of public transport, it must be encouraged because sustainable transport policy is developed. Now no smoking zone, smoking bars are public policies including criminal laws and occupational safety and health regulation that prohibit tobacco smoking in workplaces and other public spaces. Now smoking bars, these are the public policies including criminal laws and occupational safety and health regulation that forbids tobacco smoking in the workplaces and even the public spaces. The rationale for smoking bars deposits that smoking is optional Whereas breathing is not. Now, rationale for smoking bars. It shows that smoking is optional whereas breathing is not. Therefore, proponents says smoking bars are enforced to protect people from effects of passive smoking. And for this reason, proponents says smoking bars, they are enforced to protect the people from the effects of the passive smoking, which includes increased risk of heart disease, cancer, etc. And it includes increased risk of heart disease, cancer, etc. Restricted use of fossil fuels. Fossil fuels are important part of our daily life today. Now, fossil fuels, these are an important part of our today's life. Natural gas, coal and oil are the world's primary and most important source of energy. Now, natural gas, coal and oil, these are today's world, these are the most important and primary source of energy. Now, revise this chapter again. And with this, I'm ending my today's class. Goodbye.